Bismillah. Assalamu alaikum to all of my watchers. So, I have this big thing that I love watching conversion videos. It's starting to be a problem. And I love watching them because they help me reaffirm my faith that yes, this is what I believe, this is what I love. So I'd like to share mine today if it's okay. My name is Noor. And I was born and raised in the U.S. to a Jewish mother and a father of indeterminate faith. So when I was 4 years old, they told me, okay, you can go to church with your grandma and grandpa, or you can go to the temple with your brothers and sister. It's your choice. And I very wisely chose to go to the temple. And so going forward a little bit more, when I was 9 years old, I became extremely ill with a neurological condition. It's really pretty rare, but it's one that causes problems like muscle loss or muscle mass loss and loss of motor function. So walking became really difficult, but one of the worst ones was buttoning buttons. Is just so hard when your hands don't work. So, yeah, that was me at 9. And so I've received, alhamdulillah, I've received IV treatment. I was on IV treatment for 11 and a half years. And then, alhamdulillah, I'm okay now. So, during my struggles with the illness, I had a crisis of faith that just left me shaken. Here I am, 9 years old, freaking out, like, why is God doing this to me? What? And the synagogue was having some internal difficulties, whatever they may be. And they left us without the support that I so certainly needed. And I was severely depressed. I was suicidal at times, and I was searching for answers. So at 13, I was bat mitzvahed and began helping as a teaching assistant at the university. I was still pursuing other avenues, though, as I felt there had to be more than what Judaism offered. I looked into Christianity, but I couldn't deal with the Trinity or the people cramming Jesus at me all the time. Buddhism, I just wasn't that big of a hippie, and that's what it meant to me at the time. Paganism, which I actually stuck with for a while, but there was too much to remember, and it wasn't more about Allah or God, it was more focused on being selfish. So that one was a little iffy for me. But I never thought about Islam. Islam for me was oppressed women, it was Arabs who stole our land, and terrorists. Astaghfirullah. Because I was still depressed and I felt very, very, very empty inside, I did what any normal person would do. I distracted myself and I self-mutilated. I used substances, I used people, I used bad means to fill that gaping wound. When looking back at the things I did or the person I was, I am filled with regret and repentance. I mean, you add to that an unstable home life and an unhealthy love life, and I was going straight for rock bottom. So I chose to go to the party school, and I went on for 2 years in my self-destructive ways. This was no means, you know, oh, 5 months. Mm-mm. And then in one day, everything kind of started to change. We had some evangelical Christians, who we call the crazy ones, and they were seriously off their rockers, came to campus, and they had this giant banner that said, warning, laundry list of people, you will be judged. And Muslims were on the list, atheists were on the list, pagans, money lovers, baby-killing women. It was on and on and on and on and on. And I got to observe my first hijabi standing up for herself and Islam, arguing intelligently with these people about what she saw was wrong with the poster. And so, you know, I was watching her, and this guy comes up to me, and he goes, "Hey, do you have a..." I kind of looked at him. He didn't know the word for lighter, for cigarette. And so I gave it to him, and he and I started to become friends. His name is Khalid. He's a Saudi exchange student. And he had only been in the country for like two days when I met him. So he's a pretty cool dude. So after everything finished, I went up to the hijabi and said, "Man, you're really brave. I want to applaud you on that." She just kind of was like, "Oh, thanks, okay." And I know her today as a very strong, very proud individual. So time went on, and I met more and more Saudis through the dorms where I was working as a residential assistant, or through Khalid, or through any other number of sources. And we'd all hang out. Like, if I were at work and my kids were asleep, we would come down the stairs. We'd hang out. We'd talk all night, and we'd joke, and we'd laugh, and it was great. But every morning at about the same time when the sun was about to start rising, they would excuse themselves for like 10 minutes. They wouldn't even necessarily say, "Hey, I'm going to go pray Fajr." They just said, "I'll be right back." And then 10 minutes later, they'd come back and they'd be full of light and calm and just peaceful. And if drinking was involved, they were usually sure to be sober at that.